Yeah, so this is the wall switch in the bathroom. This is the light for the vanity. And then this was the switch that used to control the heat lamp in the ceiling. So I only had this one switch position, and there's just one wire that runs up to the attic. This is actually a Z-Wave switch from GE. It has four separate on-off toggles, so I can turn the ceiling light on and off right there. This is the night light. This will be the fan. Don't have a use for the fourth position yet, but I can also control other things. I could turn on the hall light or pretty much anything I want here. I can set up scenes or groups. This switch here is just under the faceplate. It doesn't have any wires hooked to it. It's battery operated and it communicates via Z-Wave. You don't even have to have a hole in the wall to put it in. It just can sit there behind the switch plate here. Linking those switch buttons to these various Z-Wave scenes allows me to manually control the lights. I find that's helpful because sometimes the logic decides to turn the light on when I don't really need it, so I can turn it off manually. And sometimes, like if the battery in the motion sensor gets low, it might not pick you up walking into the bathroom at night, so you can turn the light on. It's always good to have some manual override. And then, as you saw, I have the original vanity light on a separate switch, mainly because I couldn't figure out a way to automate that. How do you tell when you want to look in the mirror versus not look in the mirror? So the nice thing about this system is that I could mock up all the switch modules with little night lights, and then I set up the motion sensor. And once I got it all working as desired, I just unplugged the Z-Wave modules, took them up in the attic, and reconnected them to the fan. Just use the old heat lamp wire for power to the outlet box. And since that wire was the original ceiling light, or it was actually a heat lamp, it was on a separate circuit from the bathroom outlets, so that still meets code. And I didn't have to run any new wires in the walls or cut any new electrical boxes in to add additional switches. That would have been difficult since the area right over the bathrooms had a large gas furnace installed sometime after the house was built, and that has ductwork and plumbing and venting all over the top of the bathroom area. So I'm still working on getting the second fan installed. That's the one I showed you the pictures of at the beginning here. And then I'll run the exhaust ductwork between the two fans and then out through an existing roof vent. And then I can add the code to control the exhaust fan. There's an example on the Get Vera forum where you basically use the humidity sensor and run the fan until the humidity comes below a certain percentage, and you turn the fan on automatically when it goes above a certain percentage. So that way it's nice if it's a cold, humid winter day and you take a shower, the fan might stay on longer than it would on a hot, dry summer day. So that saves energy and also controls the humidity, which is the whole point. I think it's great having control over all the features, and I can do it right here. I can do it on a tablet, and I really like having that LED nightlight come on at night. It's just enough light to see with not enough to zap your night vision. Walked into the bathroom, and there we go. Got the nightlight turned on, and over there is the motion sensor. And so this is all controlled off the VeraLIte home automation controller. Just walk in the room and it turns on the light, and the nightlight's enabled anytime it's after sunset and before sunrise. So in the daytime, I have a 32 watt CFL bulb, and it comes on anytime the light level is below 3 lux in the room here. So just wanted to show you that nightlight sensor, that it works. And there's no fumbling around in the dark to find the light switch. I can leave the light on when I leave the bathroom, since it turns off automatically in a few minutes. And the cost of the home automation components was about the same as what I saved on the two fan units over the fully automated versions. Had I not messed up and ordered the wrong fans, I wouldn't have this nifty Z-Wave system to play with. Here's my bathroom. I've got the wall switch, the ceiling light. You can see here it's reporting the 32 watts that the CFL uses. And if I turn on the night light, it's reporting 1 watt. So it actually records the power being used. Here's the current temperature in the bathroom. Here's the humidity. Here's the current light reading, 116 lux. And here's the motion sensor, and it even reports the battery voltage. So you basically group all of your devices by room, and then I have this single program logic event generator that controls all these devices. So I'll show you some of the other things I've done with the system in upcoming videos, so stay tuned for those. If you have any questions or further requests on home automation, post them up in the comment section below. Be sure to rate and share this video if you liked it. Feel free to check out some of my other home automation videos and subscribe to this channel for future updates. And as always, thanks for watching.